Humans have been pretty destructive during our struggle to develop technologies and create feats of engineering that seems now to have been an essential part of our learning process. We had to develop in a way that would enable us to look for a better, cleaner way to develop, a more substantial way if we were to survive more than a few millennia. But during this process of heavy industry, we took very little notice of ancient times to the point that didn't even consider that the ancient world may have advanced further than we have today. The result of this way of thinking was in that of ignorance, and we are going to give you guys one example of this. The Govan stones were situated on the banks of the River Clyde in Scotland, and during the Industrial Revolution, the stones became part of the site of the famous shipbuilders Harland and Wolff, who started shipbuilding on the Clyde right around the start of the 20th century, during which time the Govan stones survived and were even preserved at this location. But when the shipyards were demolished in 1988, 40 of the ancient stones were destroyed, apparently being mistaken for debris. Now, the most frustrating thing about this story was the fact that no one seemed to even care. This was a town that relied on the shipyards to survive. So a bunch of ancient stones of massive historical importance was not even on the agenda. Nobody even noticed the stones had been removed and destroyed for years. 5 of the stones did not fall victim to the shocking ignorance and remain on permanent display at Govan's old parish. They weigh right around a half ton each, so they are significant. The fact so many were demolished in 1988 is an absolute disgrace. 20 ton of ancient history destroyed without even batting an eyelid. Anyway, the centerpiece of the collection is the sarcophagus, which is thought to commemorate Saint Constantine, the son of Pictish King Kenneth MacAlpin. It features carvings of hunting scenes and warrior figures. Carved from solid stone, the sarcophagus is the only one of its kind in Britain, and hardly any records at all survived in Britain of 9th century events. So this was a very significant site that has been mostly lost here. Govan is believed to have been part of a kingdom ruled from Dumbarton Rock, known as Alt Clut, the Rock of the Clyde. During the Viking Age, perhaps following the sack of Dumbarton Rock in 878, Govan is believed to have been one of the major centers of the kingdom of Strathclyde, if not the major center. No historical sources gives any firm information on the boundaries of the kingdom of Strathclyde, but suggestions have been offered on the basis of place names and topography. Near the north end of Loch Lomond, which can be reached by boat from the Clyde, lies the Rock of the Britons, which is thought to have gained its name as a marker at the northern limit of the Alt Clut. The Campsie Fells and the marshes between Loch Lomond and Stirling may have represented another boundary. To the south, the kingdom extended some distance up the Strath of the Clyde, and along the coast probably extended south towards Ayr. The Govan stones were thought to have been commissioned to commemorate the power and wealth of the kings and rulers of Strathclyde, dating back to the 9th and 11th centuries when the Vikings raided the Clyde region. The Vikings destroyed Dumbarton at the mouth of the Clyde in 870 AD. This fortress was the center of an ancient kingdom of Britons. Govan gained great strategic importance as a new dynasty was established in the kingdom of Strathclyde. Govan Parish Church became an important ecclesiastical center for this new kingdom. These large sandstone blocks were found exclusively in areas of northern Britain where the Vikings settled and were used to make tombs look like mighty buildings in the Norse style. Nowhere else are there hogback stones quite as large as the 5 that are still partially intact in Govan. The sarcophagus was discovered in the graveyard in 1855 when a grave was being dug to the southeast of the church. Recognizing their significance and to protect the stones from the elements, they were moved from the surrounding graveyard and placed on display within the church itself in 1926. Until that point, the stones had lain undisturbed for over 1,000 years. The British Museum affirmed the importance of the collection when they have took one of the hogback stones to London as part of the exhibition Vikings, Life and Legend. In August 2017, the Govan stones were voted Scotland's best hidden gem in a nationwide competition, receiving more than 2,000 votes in the nationwide poll. Govan ceased to be important at the start of the 12th century when Glasgow emerged as one of the centers of the newly ascendant kingdom of Scotland. This massive changing of the old order meant that the old kingdom has been largely lost to history, and only fragmentary records remain. The tombstones at Govan were reused in the 17th and 18th centuries by local worthies, such as the Rowan family and William Bogle, whose name is inscribed into one of the ancient stones. One of the stones was found in Jordan Hill, on the other side of the river, where it had stood in the garden of one of the parishioners who had been given it as a gift. Such a shame 40 were completely destroyed, but at least now we are starting to recognize the significance of these things which tell part of history. The fact that so little is known about this period in history is incredible. It really was not that long ago if you think about it. That's it for now, guys. We wanted to bring you this little piece of history. We were reading about the rise and fall of the shipyards in Scotland on the River Clyde and how they once made an incredible quarter of all the world's shipping for over 100 years or so when we came across this little piece of lost history. The history of shipbuilding in Glasgow alone is absolutely astonishing. This is one of the great centers of the Industrial Revolution that provided essential stepping stones as we develop our culture and civilization into a more substantial one. We will leave some links below for you to go and check that out for yourself. I wanted to take a moment and thank all of you for your continued support. Like the Lost History Channel, I have my own channel where I cover gaming, reviews, how-to, and current events. Although I don't go into historical material on my channel, you may find my Friday vlogs, which covers current events in our world, entertaining and engaging. Your support for our channels have really given us an opportunity to bring you guys the quality presentations you've come to expect. So for me and the Lost History Channel, thank you for your continued support. We hope you guys have enjoyed this information we have presented to you today. Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching.